Hello and welcome to News Pulse. I'm Esther. These are the headlines. A total of 15 ministers to be part of the new cabinet of Punjab Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Chani took oath on Sunday at the Raj Bhavan in Chandigarh, a week after Chani's name was announced as the new Chief Minister of the poll-bound state. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath expanded his cabinet on Sunday evening, inducting seven new ministers. Jitin Prasada was inducted as a cabinet minister, while six others, Chhatrapal Singh Gangwar, Paltu Ram, Sangeeta Balwant, Sanjeev Kumar, Dinesh Kartik and Dharamveer Singh were administered oath as ministers of state. Two people have been arrested by the special cell of the Delhi police 2 days after a jailed gangster and his two attackers were killed in a shootout inside a Delhi courtroom. Prime Minister Narendra Modi urged people to celebrate the River Festival on the occasion of World River Day on Sunday to connect with the traditions which are associated with rivers for centuries in the country. Now for the news and details. The citizens of Aboy town in Mon district have been combating and braving the COVID-19 pandemic with grit and very interestingly with only one dental surgeon sanctioned at the community health center to aid the patients and especially those infected with COVID-19 since its outbreak. During the first phase of the pandemic, only the dentist was available to take care of the patients at the CHC, said a member of the Aboy Area Forum. But now, along with the dentist, is a general doctor. Even though Mon did not record any new cases as of September 26, the CHC was said to be in a deplorable condition throughout. Only after the community came together for social work and with their own funding, some renovation was possible. With shortage of manpower still at the CHC, not only for COVID-19 but also various other sicknesses and patients that come from other parts of Mon, the Aboy CHC is said to be in dire need of more professionals and staff. The Aboy public have been involved in community participations for the past few years and tremendous changes have taken place at the CHC Aboy. But with patients coming in every day with various ailments, duties of the medical staff has to be available for 24/7. Amongst others, the Aboy Town Students Union have also been in the forefront in making sure that the CHC is able to cater to the public as much as possible. To speak more on this, we have the president of the Aboy Town Students Union, Mankat Kaihe Konyak. Hello, Mankat.
Yes.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, madam.
Yes, yes.
Okay,
I wanted to ask you about this Aboy Community Health Center. We were told that only a dentist was available during the first phase of the pandemic, of the COVID-19 pandemic. Is this true?
Yes, it is true. First of all, thank you, Humble TV, for this opportunity.
Okay.
No, before highlighting this COVID-19, I would like to share some few words regarding the CHC Aboy, that the conditions of the CHC Aboy at the present state.
Mm-hmm.
Madam?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, I can hear you.
CHC Aboy is one of the neglected community health centers in Nagaland. The populations of more than 30 villages rely on it for health issues.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas CHC Aboy is in a very sorry state. Lack of manpower is the main cause behind the deplorable conditions of the CHC Aboy.
Mm-hmm.
The community health center has shortage of medical officers, no posting of XMO since 6 years back, and shortage of staff, nurses and other field staff.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
How
did Aboy CHC manage to cater to so many patients, not only for COVID-19, but different ailments during such a time, during a pandemic, during lockdown, when there's nobody around, you know, to take care of the needs of the people also, and including doctors, nurses? How did one dentist, how did Aboy manage to do this?
During the pandemic, many of the patients rely on the pharmacist. Some of the pharmacists were run by the medical practitioner. Because of this, many complaints have arisen in Aboy. because of this, the NGOs of Aboi has shut down many pharmacies.
Yes. So even the CHC being, catered by a dentist also during the pandemic, won't it be an obstruction to medical laws also, because, the medical malpractice can happen?
We have appealed to the government regarding this, regarding the induction of manpower in Aboi for many times, but we have not received any positive response so far. Because of this, we have even gone for this press leave of CHC Aboi voluntarily by our own, in our own capacity. Like some of the judges, they come up, and the NGOs of Aboi, some organizations of Aboi have come up and do some press leave to the CHC Aboi, so that we understand or we expect that government can be understood that the people of Aboi are so much cooperative.
How many patients come to the CHC on a daily basis or weekly? How many patients is there a minimum of?
Nearly 100 patients per day.
100 patients per day. So, still it is understaffed and manpower shortage is there. So, has the government done anything to make sure that this is not happening? Have they come forward?
No, we haven't got any positive response so far. We have appealed to the government many times. And lately, recently, one of the doctors, Dr. Hangsa, has been appointed in CHC Aboi, much to our relief.
Okay.
But still, there is a shortage of manpower in CHC Aboi.
Okay, so the government has not come forward. And is there any ultimatum that the organizations and unions in Aboi want to take up?
I didn't want to appeal the government of Nagaland to kindly induct manpower of CHC Aboi as per mentioned in the guidelines. Because the present strength of the CHC Aboi is very less than the CHC.
Okay. Then what is the next step that the union wants to take in regard to this? And how will patients that come to CHC be catered to with only two doctors, and that is including one dentist? So how is Aboi going to handle this if patients come for different ailments, not just for COVID-19?
We have no test, but we have to refer to some other test to the other district headquarters,
okay,
hospital or somewhere in Dimapur like this.
Okay.
Otherwise, we have no choice.
No choice but to send the patients to other districts or Mon town. Okay.
Yes, yes.
All right. Thank you, Mankad, for speaking with us.
Thank you.
A total of 15 ministers is to be part of the new cabinet of Punjab Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Chani, who took oath on Sunday at the Raj Bhavan in Chandigarh, a week after Chani's name was announced as the new Chief Minister of the poll-bound state. After Chani's swearing in on Monday, rounds of discussion were held to finalize the names of the new ministers. Sunday's cabinet expansion and swearing in follow the Chief Minister's recent visit to New Delhi, where the new inclusions have been vetted by the High Command. However, at the last moment, a controversy erupted with six MLAs objecting to Rana Gurjit Singh's inclusion in the cabinet. Rana Gurjit Singh was dropped from the cabinet in January 2018 because of his alleged involvement in the mining scandal. The leaders demanded that the cabinet berth should go to a clean Dalit leader. The ministers who took oath on Sunday are Brahm Mohindra, Manpreet Singh Badal, Tripti Rajinder Singh Bajwa, Sukhbinder Singh Sarkaria, Rana Gurjit Singh, Aruna Chaudhary, Razia Sultana, Bharat Bhushan Ashu, Vijay Inder Singla, Randeep Singh Nabha, Raj Kumar Varka, Sangat Singh Gilzian, Parghat Singh, Amarinder Singh Raja Waring, and Gukrirat Singh Kotli. Special Relief Commissioner P.K. Jenna has given updates on the evacuation deployment of 24 NDRF and 42 ODRAF teams in 11 coastal and South Odisha districts of Odisha. More than 5,000 people have been evacuated in Gajapati and Ganjam district. Schools and colleges of Ganjam, Gajapati and some other districts will be closed tomorrow. Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik talked with the DMs of 11 cyclone affected districts. In other news, the police have arrested one terrorist associated with the resistance front from near Jammu railway station on September 26 and one pistol and 7 cartridges recovered from his possession. In an official statement, SOG, the accused is identified as Sheikh Sunan Yusuf alias Raja alias Sultan. The case has been registered against the accused under UAPA and Arms Acts. Further details are awaited, informed Jammu and Kashmir Police. After the shout-out inside the Rohini court, questions may arise about the presence of such dreaded gangsters and their gangs in Delhi and about police actions against them. How far police have succeeded in their endeavours to put them behind the bars.
The appointed Delhi police under Commissioner Rakesh Asthana has adopted zero tolerance against organised crime. Commissioner of Police has instructed that there should be stern action against gang. All units have been roped into action against organised crime and criminals. Binda specialised units, special cell and crime branch have a bit more to do. Speaking to ANI exclusively, the Joint Commissioner of Police Crime Branch, Alok Kumar, said there are 26 identified gangs in Delhi with a total of 188 identified gang members. Out of these, 107 have been arrested. Alok Kumar gave the insight of police strategies, organized crime networks and gangsters' modus operandi and their hierarchy. On the question of how the most organized crime linked to these gangs happening despite the fact the leaders been in jail, the officer said this simply shows that the links are there outside the jail, which keeps the action alive. In the operations, police is using human intelligence, technology and all possible mediums against their linkage and have been very successful in recent days.
The organized crime or interstate gangs ke saath unke upar shikanja kasna hai, jo organized crime hai aur interstate nature ka jo crime hai, usko jar se safaya karna hai shahar se, aur iske liye district police, क्राइम ब्रांच और स्पेशल सेल तीनों टीमें जो हैं वो बहुत ही मुस्तैदी से काम कर रही हैं कंटिन्यूसली. हाल फिलहाल के अंदर ये अगर हम देखें तो चाहे वो ड्रग पेडलर्स हों, गन रनर्स हों या इंटर स्टेट गैंग के क्रिमिनल्स हों, उनके ऊपर बहुत ही एक्शन हुआ है और उसमें बहुत सारे बंद किए गए हैं.
Ahead of cabinet announcement late in the afternoon, Punjab Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Channi on Sunday visited the Kartar Singh Wala village of Bathinda to take stock of the cotton crop destroyed due to the pink bollworms infestation. Channi was accompanied by Deputy Chief Minister Sukhjinder Randhwa. He has directed the officials to ensure that farmers' crops are not damaged at any cost, the CM tweeted. Farmers are Punjab's backbone and the government will provide them all the necessary support, the CM tweeted. Punjab government is a simple government and its first step would be to treat the problem, and for that it will spray insecticides for free, Channi said. During his visit, Channi hugged a farmer and said that the compensation would reach the farmers directly, and unlike older government, no middleman, no policy would get a share of it. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath expanded his cabinet Sunday evening, inducting 7 new ministers. Jitin Prasada was inducted as a cabinet minister, while 6 others, Chhatapal Singh Gangwar, Paltu Ram, Sangeeta Balwant, Sanjeev Kumar, Dinesh Karthik and Dharmveer Singh, were administered oath as ministers of state. With their induction, the strength of the Uttar Pradesh cabinet has gone up to 60. Brahmin leader Prasada had jumped ship from Congress to BJP earlier this year amid the Saffron Party's internal worries about the thin representation of the community in the party.
ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि मैं विधि द्वारा स्थापित भारत के संविधान के प्रति सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगा. मैं भारत की प्रभुता और अखंडता क्षुण रखूंगा. मैं उत्तर प्रदेश राज्य के मंत्री के रूप में अपने कर्तव्यों का श्रद्धापूर्वक और शुद्ध अंतकरण से निर्वहन करूंगा तथा मैं भय या पक्षपात, अनुराग या द्वेष के बिना सभी प्रकार के लोगों के प्रति संविधान और विधि के अनुसार न्याय करूंगा.
मैं
राज्य के मंत्री के गोपनीयता की शपथ. मैं जितिन प्रसाद ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि जो विषय उत्तर प्रदेश राज्य में मंत्री के रूप में मेरे विचार के लिए लाया जाएगा अथवा मुझे ज्ञात होगा उसे किसी व्यक्ति या व्यक्तियों को तब तक सिवाय जबकि ऐसा मंत्री के रूप में अपने कर्तव्यों के सामूहिक निर्वहन के लिए ऐसा करना उपेक्षित हो मैं प्रत्यक्ष अथवा अप्रत्यक्ष रूप से संसूचित या प्रकट नहीं करूंगा।
In a bid to go completely paperless and keep board results secure and tamper-proof, the Central Board of Secondary Education has introduced blockchain technology. Speaking to ANI on Sunday, CBSE Director of Information and Technology, Antariksh Johri, said blockchain implementation has been done by the CBSE. Earlier, the establishment introduced artificial intelligence and machine learning for affiliation systems, Johri said. Here, the data is linked and stored with cryptographic security so that it is immutable and traceable, Johri said. India's Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla, on PM Modi's participation in Quad Leaders Summit, stated that unity is very pertinent when it comes to Afghanistan. Unity is very pertinent when it comes to Afghanistan, when the Quad meeting was very useful in putting together the objectives the leaders had for Afghanistan, said the Foreign Secretary.
Our interests converged and our interests were really reflected in the points that I made earlier. And from that point of view, I think the Quad was very, it was a very useful meeting in putting together the thinking and the objectives that the Quad leaders had in Afghanistan, bringing them on the same page. I think, Siddhant, you spoke about Pakistan's support for terrorism. Again, you would have seen that in all the meetings the Prime Minister had, beginning with US leadership, there was suo motu recognition of the concerns that Pakistan represents as a country that has, in many senses, both supported and nurtured cross-border terrorism, including in Afghanistan and from Afghanistan. There was a sense that that situation needs to be watched very carefully.
That's all for News Pulse. I'm Esther. Keep watching Hornbill TV.